Hi, in this video we will be covering about how to get a variable DC voltage supply. What we have is a 230 volt 50 hertz AC.
If we are connecting a full bridge rectifier to the supply, we will get a rectified output as shown in the figure. Here the average DC output voltage is constant.
You know that a diode will start conducting when we are applying a positive voltage across the anode and cathode. This voltage should be greater than the forward blocking voltage. What if there is a diode-like device which can be turned on only when we are applying a gate signal? This device is called an SCR or thyristor. If we are replacing two diodes in the bridge rectifier with two SCRs, then we will get a semi-controlled converter. And if all the diodes are replaced with SCR, then it will become a fully controlled converter. In the lab, we are using semi-controlled converter. The output of the converter will be connected to the armature winding or field winding. The armature circuit of the machine can be modeled as an RL load. Here, EB represents the back EMF. Assume that we are applying a gate pulse at time t1. Note that at this instant, the instantaneous value of AC voltage VAC is greater than the back EMF EB. Current will start to flow from the source to the load through the thyristor t1 and diode d2. The output voltage is VAC at this time. Current starts to decrease after the instant where VAC equals EB. This instant is represented by a blue dotted line. At T2, negative half cycle will begin. The current cannot continue the path through thyristor T1 and diode D2 since D2 will be reverse biased in this condition. So, the current starts to freewheel through the diodes D1 and D2 as shown. At this time, the output voltage is the voltage across the diodes,
which is approximately equal to 0.
Once the current becomes 0, that is at time T3, the voltage across the terminals will be the back EMF EB. In negative half cycle, the thyristor T2 and D1 will conduct and the output voltage is minus VAC. This cycle repeats. So in order to change the average voltage, we have to change the thyristor firing angle. Let's see how it actually works. At the starting condition, the firing angle is close to 180 degree. I am going to reduce the firing angle. Observe the current and voltage waveform. When I am reducing the firing angle, the average voltage increases and you can see the back EMF rising. Let's pause and see the three different modes. Now the rated voltage is applied to the motor. Let's load it. Notice the current waveform. You can see it increases.
Here we have a DC motor and a DC generator which are mechanically coupled. The armature of this DC generator is connected to the lamp loads. So if I am switching the lamp loads, this will load the DC motor. In this experiment, we will be operating this DC motor at three different speeds.
Below rated speed, at rated speed, and above rated speed. Up to the rated speed, we will keep the field voltage constant and we will vary the armature voltage from 0 to the rated value. And for above rated operation, we will keep the armature voltage constant and we will reduce the field voltage.
So we have covered the basics and you are all set to go for the experiment. Before that, I have some questions for you. Why are we doing this experiment? Or what you will gain from this experiment? What are the extra knowledge that you can attain from this? And why are we doing this speed torque characteristics? Before doing an experiment, we should know what's the outcome of that experiment. Or we should at least have an expectation. Think about it and see you in lab. Bye.